Hello everyone. Am I audible, dear?
Yes, sir.
We have discussed till year, na? Have we discussed year? Tell me.
Yes, sir, we'll discuss.
Year were completed in the previous class. Mechanism of hearing.
Yes, sir.
Read out NCRT, and if you have any doubt, you can ask me. Okay. Now, chemical control and coordination. Let's see, dear. What happens in chemical control and coordination? What is coordination actually? Coordination is the process, process by which one or more organ or organ system work together to perform functions. Like you are running, which system is used? A skeletal system is used, but along with that only, heartbeat increases, respiratory rate increases. Getting my point? Means once a skeletal system starts working, you can say along with that, the circulatory system as well as respiratory system also started working. Yes or no? And everything comes to normal once we stop performing work. Agreed, dear? Tell me that first.
Yes, sir.
Yes, that is known as coordination. Coordination is of two types. Okay, you people can write down this thing. Done, everyone? Done, dear?
Sir, just a second, sir.
No issues.
Done, sir.
Done. Let's see one more thing. Coordination in human body is brought about by two systems. One is the nervous system, okay, and one is endocrine system. The coordination brought about by nervous system is known as neural control and coordination, and by endocrine system, chemical coordination. Yes or no? Agreed?
Yes.
Agreed? Here are the differences. You people can note down. I think that is too simple. You will understand now. You can say without any interference only. Done, dear. Neural coordination is fast. Chemical is slow. Neural is point to point. It is diffuse and long lasting. It is brought about by nervous system and it is brought about by endocrine system. Yes or no? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Endocrine system in human consists of endocrine glands and hormones. Let's see. The endocrine glands. These are the endocrine glands of human. There are three in the brain: hypothalamus, pineal, and pituitary. Two are there: thyroid and parathyroid. Parathyroid is situated on the back side of thyroid only. Here is the thymus, pancreas, and adrenal gland. And in females, ovary is found. In males, testis is found. Together, they are going to be known as gonads. Together they are going to be known as gonads. Yes or no? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
See over here. So this is there. Can write down. In brain, three are there. Remember it like that only.
Done, sir.
Done. Let's see. I will be asking about hypothalamus. You can say, but telling you people about hypothalamus and pituitary at the same time. Getting my point? First thing is development of pituitary gland. Actually, pituitary gland is ectodermal in origin. What is the origin of pituitary gland? It is ectodermal. Agreed? It is ectodermal. Getting my point? How it develops? This is the diencephalon part of the brain, and this is the primitive gut. Primitive gut. From the gut, here is developing a Rathke's pouch. What? Rathke's pouch. Agreed, dear?
Yes.
Yes. Let's see. What happens? This is the evagination formed from hypothalamus. Diencephalon only. This blue color. And this Rathke's pouch got broken and get itself, you can say, surrounded around the this part. Okay. The part that is developing from the diencephalon is known as neurohypophysis. What? Neurohypophysis. This is the blue color part. And the part which is developing from Rathke's pouch, that is known as adenohypophysis. What? Adenohypophysis. Adenohypophysis consists of pars tuberalis, pars distalis or anterior lobe, and pars intermedia or middle lobe of pituitary gland. Yes or no? Everyone? Everyone? Yes. So, it is developing from the two places. And it is having two component, adenohypophysis and neurohypophysis. Adenohypophysis having three component, pars tuberalis, this is the part which is surrounded around the infundibulum. Infundibulum is the stalk that connect hypothalamus to pituitary gland. Agreed, dear, everyone?
Yes, sir.
So pars tuberalis, pars intermedia, and pars distalis are the three component of adenohypophysis. Agreed, everyone? Write down.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
So what is the primitive gut again?
Primitive gut. Gut is your GIT, gastrointestinal system. And the primitive is when it is in the early stage of development.
Yes, sir. Got
it. Yes or no?
So, could you scroll down a bit?
Yes.
So could you Done. Scroll to the adrenohypophysis part? Done, sir.
Done, everyone. So this is the component of pituitary. Getting my point? Now, this diagram. What this diagram is showing? Let's see. Actually, what happens? These are the nuclei. These are the nuclei. Nuclei. Do you know what is the meaning of nucleus in central nervous system? What is nucleus, dear?
So cluster of cell bodies.
Collection of cell bodies. कहां पर? In CNS. Agreed, dear? Collection of cell bodies in CNS is the nucleus. Okay, so these are the arcuate, supraoptic, and paraventricular nucleus. Yes or no, dear? Yes?
Yes.
You see how it is secreting over here. This is superior hypophyseal artery. It is breaking into capillaries over here and it is coming down to the pituitary. Okay. Means anything that is coming to hypothalamus, to anterior pituitary or adenohypophysis, that comes through this. This is hypophyseal portal vein. That comes through hypophyseal portal vein. Yes or no? Agreed? Agreed? Agreed, dear? Hypophyseal portal vein only. Okay. But this part, posterior pituitary, is connected to hypothalamus through axons of these nuclei. Means there is direct axonal connection between hypothalamus and posterior pituitary, and anterior pituitary, or rather adenohypophysis, is connected to hypothalamus through hypophyseal portal vein. Getting my point? So things are, the secretion of posterior pituitary is there, na? It is synthesized in these nuclei, transported through axons, and only released from what? From posterior pituitary. So if somebody will ask you, secretion of posterior pituitary is synthesized in, what will you say? What will you say?
So the nuclei.
Nuclei. It is there in the hypothalamus only. Secretion of posterior pituitary is synthesized in hypothalamus. Agreed? Transported axonally to posterior pituitary and is stored and released from the posterior pituitary. Yes or no? Tell me.
Yes, sir.
Secretion from hypothalamus reaches adenohypophysis through hypophyseal portal vein. Agreed, dear everyone?
Yes, sir.
Getting my point? So secretion of anterior pituitary is synthesized in anterior pituitary only controlled by hypothalamus. But secretion of posterior pituitary is synthesized in hypothalamus, only released and stored from posterior pituitary. Yes or no?
Yes.
So what is the site of synthesis of hormones of posterior pituitary?
So the nuclei in the hypothalamus.
Yeah. Please write down.
So are the axons specialized to carry chemicals, or are they
the yes. normal axons? Yes, it will be transported. Anything that is synthesized in the cell body, that come to the axon terminal. Usually.
So, the chemicals are not in the synaptic knobs. They're just transported through the axon.
Yes. it is transported like that only. Actually, they are modified neurons. They are known as neurosecretory cell.
So can they also transmit action potential or only
only carry hormones? They are not going to they are not specialized for conduction. They got modified for secretion.
Yes, sir. Got.
Agreed, dear? Done. Everyone?
Just a minute, sir. So could you write the name of the nuclei like on the side or something? It's not visible.
Is it visible now? Arcuate supraoptic paraventricular.
Got it, sir.
Dangier. These two lines are very important. Pay attention to them. Now, hormones secreted by hypothalamus. Actually, hypothalamus is the floor of diencephalon. Already we have discussed that. It controls the pituitary. In the old terminology, pituitary is known as master gland. So hypothalamus at times is known as master of master gland because it is going to control the pituitary. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So hypothalamus secretes two groups of hormone. One is the releasing hormone. Another is inhibiting hormone. If releasing hormone is going to be released, it stimulates the secretion of anterior pituitary. And if inhibiting hormone is going to be released, it is going to stop or decrease the secretion of anterior pituitary. For example, GHRH is growth hormone, releasing hormone released from hypothalamus. And once it is released, it increases secretion of growth hormone. Yes or no? And inhibiting hormone is, it is going to inhibit the secretion of anterior pituitary. And once it is released, it lead to decrease in the secretion of growth hormone. Agreed, dear everyone?
Yes.
Yes.
Done.
Now there are few cells which is there in the pituitary gland, and hypothalamus is going to control that. Like human growth hormone is going to be secreted by somatotroph. Okay, it is going to be acted by GHRH, which is also known as somatocrinin. Once somatocrinin will be released. Secretion of human growth hormone or somatotropin is going to be increased. Yes or no? And if GHIH or somatostatin will be secreted, its secretion is going to decrease. Yes or no? These are the hypothalamic hormone. These are the cells of pituitary. And these are the hormones secreted by anterior pituitary. Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
You people can write down. Done, everyone? Done, dear?
So just a second, sir.
You people are going for the exam in school?
Yes, sir.
When?
For YPR, exam begins next Monday.
Tomorrow exam is not there for you people, no?
No, sir, but we have practical classes tomorrow and the whole week next week.
Okay. Understood?
Yes.
These are the names of the, so you people can solve this question. Prolactin is secreted by which cell of the pituitary?
Done, sir.
Done. Now, pituitary gland, its location is inside a bony cavity present in the sphenoid bone. It is known as cella tarsica. Another name of pituitary gland is hypophysis. Okay, one is trophic hormone. Trophic hormone is one hormone that is released from one endocrine gland and acting on another, like TSH, FSH, LH, ACTH. They are released from the pituitary, acting on thyroid. Yes or no? Agreed, dear?
Yes, sir.
So this is there. Now, hormones secreted by pituitary. I will talk about hormones secreted by pituitary. First thing is hormone secreted by adenohypophysis. Adenohypophysis comprises 75% of the pituitary gland and it is having following parts: distalis, intermedia and tuberalis. Tuberalis do not secrete any hormone usually. So hormone secreted by pars distalis, GH, LH, FSH, TSH, PRL and ACTH. Yes or no?
Yes,
sir. GH, LH, FSH, TSH, and PRL. Agreed? GH is growth hormone. It is known as somatotrophin or somatotropic hormone. It regulates somatic growth of the tissue like muscle and all. Okay? Agreed, dear?
Yes.
We will talk about axon, its function, axon, skeletal system. It increases the cell number, like see. This is the diaphysis of bone. This is the epiphysis of the bone. And in between, epiphyseal plate is there. Okay, already you must be knowing they are the cartilaginous plate. They are known as growth plate also. Growth hormone act on them also. Like if I am going to take growth hormones now, no effect will be there because epiphyseal plate is closed now for me. Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So it will increase the cell number. Insulin and thyroxine also have a role for bone formation. Insulin is going to be responsible for cytoplasmic growth and thyroxine is going to be responsible for DNA replication. Osteogenesis is bone formation. Yes or no? You people can write.
Sir, could you scroll up to the hormones?
Yes.
Could you scroll down?
Done.
So just a minute, sir.
Done. Now what do you think? If your muscle has to grow, will you require protein?
Yes, sir.
So what should be the action of growth hormone on protein synthesis? It should increase, na? So it is having anabolic role. Yes or no? It is having anabolic role. Yes. Agreed, dear? Now, Ca plus 2 absorption from GIT will increase. Why? And excretion of all these things will be decreased from the kidney. Why? Because if bone has to be formed, Ca plus 2 will be required. Yes or no?
Yes.
As far as carbohydrate metabolism is concerned, it has to increase blood glucose level also, because more energy will be required for the growth. Yes or no? So,
yes.
As far as carbohydrate metabolism is concerned, growth hormone is a diabetogenic hormone, means it will increase blood glucose. Agreed? How? It is going to increase hepatic glucose output. Okay? From the liver, it will increase the glucose secretion and antagonizing the insulin will decrease the function of insulin, because insulin having the function of decreasing the blood glucose level. Na? Yes, sir. No? Understood?
Yes, sir.
You can write.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, dear.
Sir, what is the gluconeogenesis for?
Yes, we are discussing that. Let's see.
Yes.
It also increases gluconeogenesis. Gluconeogenesis, new means new. Synthesis of glucose from starch is normal, or glycogen is normal. Yes or no? Because they are made up of glucose only. So it is synthesis of glucose from a new source. And what will be the new source? It can be lactate. It can be fatty acid. It can be amino acid. Yes or no?
Yes.
From that, so it will. This process will increase the blood glucose. Yes or no? I have written the definition also. Okay. So for gluconeogenesis, we are going to require amino acid, okay, and fats also. Getting my point? And principally fat. More fat is required. So if more fat is required, because if fatty acid is required, fat has to be broken. Na? Triglycerides have to be broken. Na? If fatty acid is required in more amount. Tell me.
Yes, sir.
So what will happen? So fat, as far as fat metabolism is concerned, what will happen? Fatty acid will break. So growth hormone is going to, fatty acid is going to break, metabolized, and before that fat is going to be broken. So it will increase the free fatty acid level. Okay. And if fatty acid will be broken, it will lead to formation of ketone bodies. So it is a ketogenic hormone also. So it is increasing fatty acid in the blood. Agreed, dear?
Yes, sir. Done, sir.
It is also going to increase the milk production in lactating mothers. It is also going to increase the milk production in lactating mothers. Because for, you can say, development of mammary gland also it is required. Agree, dear? Okay. Growth hormone also stimulates erythropoiesis, formation of blood. Because in at any place, wherever, you can say, growth kind of activity is required. So primary or secondary effect will be there of growth hormone also. Yes or no? We'll talk about disorders. In case of hormones, there are two kinds of disorders. One is hypersecretion, one is hypersecretion. Hyposecretion is decreased secretion and hypersecretion is increased secretion. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Agreed? So due to hyposecretion, it is going to cause two diseases. One is dwarfism, one is acromicria. Okay, one is dwarfism, one is acromicria. Dear C, what happens due to low secretion of growth hormone before puberty? All the bone will be short. In this case, all bone will be affected. But if it will happen after puberty, most of the bone has grown already. Only few bones are affected, like bone of hand will be affected. Okay, height will be normal in this case. Hand will be shorter. Agreed? Here, height will also be less. Likewise, hypersecretion, gigantism, and acromegaly. Gigantism is due to oversecretion of growth hormone before puberty, and it is upper puberty. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no? Done? Done, dear?
Sir, just a second.
Write down these two things. Hyposecretion and hypersecretion. You can write. Done.
Yes, sir.
Let's see. One is luteinizing hormone. It is having effect on male and female and having different effect. Here, between the seminiferous tubule, later on in 12th, we are going to study this. Here is the interstitial cell. Okay, outside this lumen, here is interstitial cell. That is known as Leydig cells. So LH act on interstitial cell. Okay, hence also known as interstitial cell stimulating hormone. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes. It act on interstitial cell and bring about secretion of testosterone. And that leads to spermatogenesis. Agreed, dear? In female, LH act on mature Graafian follicle and brings about ovulation. Okay, it is a ovulatory hormone in females. Yes or no, dear?
Yes, sir.
Agreed, everyone? Now, let's see. Once this Graafian follicle ruptures, ovum is released and one more structure is formed. That structure is known as corpus luteum. Yes or no? After rupture of Graafian follicle, ovum is released and one structure is formed that is known as corpus luteum. Yes or no?
Yes.
It is having this yellow color pigment, lutein, hence known as corpus luteum. Hence known as corpus luteum. Agreed, dear? Everyone? Yes. And corpus luteum secretes progesterone and estrogen. It is situated inside ovary only. It is situated inside ovary only. So if something is getting secreted from corpus luteum, that means it is secreted from ovary only. Yes. Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes. Done.
So could you scroll up?
Yes.
Yes.
Done, everyone? What is going to happen in male and what is going to happen in female, you know? Well, especially remember corpus luteum. Agreed? Done?
Yes.
Yes. One is follicle stimulating hormone, FSH, in males and in females. In males and in females. In males, it is going to act on Sertoli cells. Which cell? Sertoli cells. Agreed here? It is going to act on Sertoli cells. And in female, it is going to act on developing follicle. See, this is the Graafian follicle. It develops through all these stages, primordial, primary, secondary, tertiary, then Graafian follicle is going to be there. And then it will form the corpus luteum in the ovary. Yes or no? Yes or no? So yes. This development is under control of what? This development is under control of what?
It's follicle stimulating hormone.
Follicle stimulating hormone in female. So once follicle will develop under the effect of FSH, and then it will burst to release ovum under the influence of LH. Yes or no, dear? Yes or no? Now,
yes.
See, testosterone is released over here. Okay. And it is required inside the lumen. What is the factor that is going to concentrate the testosterone inside the lumen? This is androgen binding protein. Androgen is the group. Testosterone is one of the member. Agreed here? Androgen is the group. Testosterone is one of the member. Yes or no, everyone?
Yes.
Done? Write down, please.
Done, sir.
Oh, sorry. I was on mute and I keep on telling you people this and that. Let's see. This is hypothalamus. This is anterior pituitary. This is thyroid gland. What is the role of TSH? Two roles are there. One is growth of thyroid gland. And another is synthesis of thyroxine inside thyroid gland. Yes or no? One is growth of thyroid gland. Another is synthesis of thyroxine inside the T3 and T4 inside the thyroid gland. Yes or no? Everyone?
Yes.
Yes. Let's see, dear. What happens? Hypothalamus is going to release TRH. This will act on anterior pituitary gland. Anterior pituitary will release TSH. It will go on thyroid gland and will bring about growth of thyroid gland and synthesis of T3 and T4 into it. When the blood level of T3 and T4 increases, it will send negative feedback to decrease secretion of TSH and TRH. Agreed? And when blood level is going to decrease, it will increase the synthesis of TSH and TRH. Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes.
Everyone? Yes or no? It is like that only. Please write down. Then we will discuss the disorder.
Done, sir.
Done. Done. Now see what happens in simple goiter. What is the problem that is going to be there in simple goiter? Iodine deficiency is there. What is there? Iodine deficiency is there. And for synthesis of T3 and T4, iodine is required. So will the level of T3 and T4 will decrease or not? Will the level of T3 and T4 will decrease or not?
Yes, sir.
It will decrease. Surely it will decrease. When it will decrease, what will happen? It will send positive feedback. And release of TSH will increase. It will act on thyroid gland and will bring about growth of thyroid gland. But will the level of T3 or T4 will increase? Will the level of T3 and T4 increase?
No, sir.
No. Why? Because iodine is not there. It will send more and more positive feedback. TSH will keep on increasing, but what will happen? TSH will keep on increasing, but what will happen? Tell me.
Level of T3 and T4 remains same.
It will not increase. It will not increase. So growth of thyroid gland will keep on taking place, but level of T3 and T4 will not increase. So in simple goiter, level of T3 and T4 will remain low. Okay. Level of T3 and T4 will remain low, but level of TSH will increase. Yes or no, dear?
Yes.
Everyone? Done?
Just a minute.
You can write down. Yeah. Please think about this. Gandhiar?
Yes, sir.
Done. Now see what happens in exophthalmic goiter. Exophthalmic goiter is an autoimmune disease. Which kind of disease? What happens in this? You can say there is some problem with your immune system, and immune system is not able to, you can say, differentiate between your own body cell and the foreign cell. Yes or no?
Yes.
Autoimmune disease. What happens in that? There is an antibody formed. There is an antibody formed which is having TSH-like activity. So what it will do? It will increase the size of thyroid gland. And as iodine level is normal at this time, so T3 and T4 level will increase. Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
And increased level will send negative feedback. TSH level will decrease. Agreed? TSH level will decrease. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
TSH level will decrease. And now see here, what will happen? But this TSH is not the culprit. Culprit is this one. So it will keep on increasing the size of thyroid gland and keep on increasing the level of T3 and T4. And this will keep on decreasing. So in exophthalmic goiter, what will happen? T3 or T4 will increase and TSH will decrease. Yes or no?
Yes.
Done? Done?
Yes, sir.
Okay, what happens in this case? The eyeball bulges out of orbit, and this condition is known as exophthalmos. Okay, exophthalmos. Agreed, everyone? Hence, this is known as exophthalmic goiter. Yes or no?
Yes.
So you understood both the disease?
Yes, sir.
Done, everyone. Now, next hormone is prolactin. Prolactin is hormone that is responsible for growth of mammary gland and also responsible for synthesis of milk into mammary gland. So it is milk synthesizing hormone. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Agreed, dear? Sorry. Done, dear, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Adrenocorticotropic hormone. Let's see. ACTH. It acts on adrenal cortex. Okay. And adrenal cortex having three layer. One is glomerulosa, one is fasciculata, and one is reticularis. Three names are there. Okay. Glomerulosa, fasciculata, and reticularis. Okay. Glomerulosa secrete aldosterone or mineralocorticoid. It is under the control of RAS that we have discussed in kidney. Renin, angiotensin, aldosterone system. Okay. Agreed?
Yes.
And secretion of zone of fasciculata and reticularis. The two layers are there. It is under control of glucocorticoid. You can say under control of ACTH. Okay, fasciculata secretes glucocorticoid. Corticoid means a hormone that is secreted by adrenal cortex. Agreed, dear?
Yes.
Okay, you can do this question. Done, everyone?
So just a minute.
done. I hope you people have understood also.
Yes, sir.
Yes. One is melanocyte stimulating hormone. It is secreted by usually pars intermedia. Okay. Act on melanocyte and pigment melanin is synthesized in the skin. It causes dark complexion. Dark color skin is there, na? It is due to MSH only. Done? Done? Everyone?
So just a second.
Yes.
Done, sir.
Done. Next is neurohypophysis. Okay, it is going to secrete a hormone oxytocin. It is secreted by paraventricular nuclei of hypothalamus. Okay, and released through pituitary, posterior pituitary. Yes or no? What it do? It is going to act on a smooth muscle. Okay, it act on the myoepithelial cells of the mammary gland and will bring about milk release. Hence, it is milk releasing hormone. Prolactin is milk synthesizing hormone. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
It causes vigorous contraction of uterus during parturition. It is the birth hormone also. At the time of ejaculation, oxytocin facilitates the transport of sperm towards the urethra. Yes or no? Everyone?
So the primary function of oxytocin is always muscle contraction?
A smooth muscle contraction.
Yes, sir. Got it.
Yes. Vasopressin is known as antidiuretic hormone. I have told you people the diagram of nephron. Do you people remember?
Yes, sir.
What does it do? It act on collecting duct and distal DCT, brings about absorption of water. Reabsorption of water, rather. Now you see, excess loss of water through urine is known as diuresis. It is preventing what? Diuresis. Hence, it is known as antidiuretic. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Done. So diabetes in, and if hyposecretion of ADH will be there, it will lead to diabetes, insipidus. Agreed, dear? Write down. Done, everyone? Done. Everyone?
So just a second.
Done, everyone. Bolo beta.
So just a second.
Oh, just a minute. Done. We'll be meeting you people in the next class, okay? Whenever it is. Read out NCRT clearly, okay? If you have any doubt or the remaining portion, that you can ask anytime. And let's see when it will be arranged. Bye. Have a good day.